I'm Fernando Serrano. I'm a tutor from Riverside Middle School, and I'm here to talk to you today about community ecology.
Community ecology relates to smaller biomes in the environment. In each location, there are several groups of species that interact with each other and live in the same land. This is what we would call a community. And this is the study of how all of these different species interact with each other. As can be seen with between predators and prey, their evolution depends on their interactions between the two species. So the community ecology would be how these species have developed over time against each other. We can also see this interaction with the trophic pyramids and the flow of the energy. From here, you can see that the producers, usually the plant life, are the ones that begin with the most energy in the pyramid, and this energy starts spreading out throughout all of the predators that can be found in this environment. So in this instance, we show the rabbits, snakes, and hawks, how the rabbits would feed on the grass. And then the snakes would feed on the rabbits, and the hawk feeds on the snake, thus producing the pyramid of energy. In this, we also have the food chains and the food webs. Here, we show the interaction between what species eats which species, and how each one interacts in a certain biome. Here, we have the ocean biome. And of course, there will be different food chains or food webs depending on which environment you're currently looking at and which species exists there. Usually you have it layered to where at the bottom you have the producers and at the top you have the predators. And with some of these, you have also the present representation of the keystone species. These are species that if anything ever happened to them, it would show a drastic change in the environment, such as with the axolotl, the top predator in a Mexican pond, or that environment itself. These are usually the most studied and the ones that keep track of how the environment is doing by scientists. With that, we conclude the intro to community ecology, and as always, tutor.com is a great resource to look for more information, and thank you for your time.